In a modest hangar on the scruffy edge of a regional UK airport lies a new chapter in space exploration. This is Virgin Orbit's Launcher 1, a rocket deployed from a plane that will take satellites to space. And Spaceport Cornwall at Newquay Airport expects this to happen for the first time next June. Getting here hasn't been easy.
It's been a long journey, lots of ups and downs. We've had funding issues, we've had Brexit, we've had changes in administration, we've had a pandemic, we've had this airport almost having to be shut because of the pandemic. So we've had a lot of challenges, but we've overcome all of them to get to the point where we're so close to launch now.
For the first of these, Virgin Orbit will use Spaceport Cornwall as little more than a runway to take off from. But construction is underway to build a facility for loading the satellites. Next will be a hangar for the specialised plane.
Even when this is all finished, there won't actually be that much more to see here. Certainly nothing to rival the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, the United States. But that small footprint is a defining feature of new space, as the insiders call it. NASA, the old giant, is stepping aside. Small, budget-conscious, commercial operators are a big part of the future.
The UK is trying to position itself as one of the main players in commercial spaceflight. The government's considering license applications from several contenders. Besides Spaceport Cornwall, they include Space Hub Sutherland, a vertical rocket launch site on the northern tip of Scotland, the Shetland Space Centre on the Scottish island of Unst, and Spaceport Snowdonia in Wales.
The past decade or so has shown us an explosion in the desire to have access to space. And that means that having launch access, having the ability to actually support launches, is a very potentially lucrative endeavour for any country to be taking part in. To have a spaceport in the UK does make a lot of sense because we want to be a part of this booming space sector.
There are other motivations. Brexit Britain wants to beat the EU and become the first European country to launch a space rocket from its own soil on the continent. Although the coming commercial space era will be much less geopolitical than the first space race last century, international rivalries do still feature. Rory Challands, Al Jazeera, Cornwall.
We're going to talk more about this now with Ezzy Pearson, a space journalist. She joins us via Skype now from Bristol in the UK. Thanks for being with us. So let me ask you, first of all, what's the motivation for all this beyond just kind of national pride and bragging rights? Are there other tangible long-term benefits to this?
Absolutely. Space is a $1 trillion industry. There's so much money that changes hands when it comes to space. It's part of the UK's. This is a part of the UK's effort to get a bigger piece of that pie, basically, and get more space industry into the UK. The UK said that it wanted to have 10% of global space industry by 2030. And so by offering launches, currently the UK is very good at building satellites, but actually if you could launch them into space, that would really help improve space industry within the UK. So that's definitely, there is very much a financial motive behind this.
There will be those people who will look at this and say, why are we spending all this money on sending people up into space when we've got bigger problems down here? This should not be a priority. How do they counter that?
Well, in this specific case, it's not sending people up into space. So the UK is very much focused on sending small satellites, specifically the ones that would be launched from UK soil. They would be monitoring satellites. They'd go into something called polar or sun synchronous orbit, which means that they always pass over the same place at the same time every day. So they're very good for monitoring things like weather, the climate, agriculture. So all of these things that help us monitor and improve a lot of those problems that people criticize the space program for exacerbating. There is some talk that the UK might develop a tourist flight launch station. And that one is a bit trickier to justify. But the hope is with that if you get more people going up into space and being able to look down on Earth from above, it'll hopefully give them a bit more perspective. But certainly when it comes to small satellite launches, there is very much a lot of good that they can do here back on Earth.
Good to speak with you, Ezzy Pearson. Thanks very much for being with us.